you, I will try to explain you about how you can construct off counter with the negative edge clock. And the flip flop that we are using here is JK flip flop. So here also we have to construct mod 4 synchronous off counter, but here we have to use negative edge clock, and the flip flop that we have to use is JK flip flop. So our first step is state diagram, and second step is number of flip flops. We can do this one first also. So number of flip flops that we have to use is can be found out using mod number less than or equal to 2 raised to power n formula. Here mod number is mod 4. So here 4 is less than or equal to 2 raised to power n, and 2 raised to power 2 is less than or equal to 2 raised to power n. So here n is equal to 2. So here number of flip flops that we have to find out, that we have to draw, is 2. We have already computed. Now we know about the mod number. So the state diagram can be constructed from this also. Here mod number is 4. So we will have bits. We will have 0 to 4 numbers. 0, 1. As it is a up counter, so the values will keep on increasing. 0, 1, 2. And then last one is 3. And then move back to the 0. In this way it will repeat. So the state diagram for this will be drawn using this. Here number of flip flops is equal to 2, and 2 flip flops will use 2 bits. So 2 bits will be like this: 0 0 0 1, which is the representation for 1. After this 2, so 1 0. After this 3, so 3 is 1 1 1 1, and then again it will move back here. So this is also a up counter. So this is the state diagram for mod 4 synchronous up counter. Okay, this is the representation for 0, 1, 2, 3. Number of bits that we have to use is 4 bits, and these 4 bits can be represented using these number of bits. So this is completed. Now we will move to our third step, which is excitation table. So the excitation table for this is also bit lengthy, but firstly just draw the JK flip-flop excitation table, as we have to make use of this, the excitation table of JK flip-flop. So I have drawn excitation table of JK flip-flop in this side. Here we will have Qn and Qn plus 1 as previous state and next state, and J and K will be our outputs. Here 0 1 cross cross is the output, and here cross cross 1 0 is the output. Cross cross will represent that we can't do anything here. It is an invalid state. We can't do anything in this. Now see the excitation table. Excitation table can be constructed like this. This is the construction when we are having number of flip flops as 2. So we will have a present state, we will have a next state, and we will have various inputs. So in our present state we will have one variable. See this. We will have one variable QA and another variable QB in our present state. And in our next state we will have one variable QA plus and next variable QB plus. We are having JA, KA, JB, KB as our inputs. So QA and QB plus will be for JA, KA flip-flop. JA and KA is first flip-flop. JB and KB is for second flip-flop. And for it, now just try to fill this excitation table. Here we are having present state as this. Now we will fill next state, which is QA and QB plus. So for this, either you can draw it using your state diagram, or you can also use a simple trick. Just see from state diagram first. If you try to draw it using complete it using state diagram, what is the state after 0 0? After 0 0 the state we are having is 0 1. So we will fill here 0 1. After 0 1 what is the state we are having? Next state is 1 0. So we will fill here 1 0. After 1 0 what is the next state? Which is, it is 1 1. And after 1 1 what is the next state? It is 0 0. So we will fill here 0 0. Either you can do this way, or you can also do it in a shortcut way, like this, these two values you will fill here, and you will move this value here, and this value here. This is also the way you can draw. So this, up to this, it is completed. Now for flip-flops inputs, we will make use of excitation table. Here, if present state and next state value is 0, 0, J value is 0. In this way, we have to move. This is for present state, this is for next state, this is for J value, this is for K value. So now fill this. If present state is 0 and next state is QA plus is 0, 0, 0. So J value is 0 and K value is cross. So here we will write 0, here we will write cross. Now we will do for second one. If present state is 0 and next state is 0, next state is 1. QA and QB, QA plus. Present state is 0 and next state is QA plus. 0, 1. 0, 1 will give us 1 cross as input. 1 cross we will write here. Now, next thing. Present state is 1 and next state is 1. 1, 1 will give us cross 0 as inputs. So, write here cross 0. Now, 1 and 0. 1 and 0. 1 and 0 will give us cross 1 as inputs. So, write here cross 1s. So, I hope you are getting this one. Now, for JB and KB, we will take present state as QB and next state as QB plus. So, when we are having 0, 1, 0, 1, JA, JB and KB will become 1 cross. So, write here 1 cross. Now, for 1, 0. For 1, 0, we will have cross 1 as inputs. So, write here cross 1. For 0, 1, for 0, 1, we will have 1 cross again. 1 cross. And for 1, 0, for 1, 0, we will have cross 1 again. So, this table is completely filled now. I have already written the decimal representation here, 0, 1, 2, 3. Now we will make Karnaugh map. We will have to make here 4 Karnaugh map. One for our first flip-flop, second for our second flip-flop. This is for our first flip-flop, this is for our second flip-flop. JA, KA, JB, KB. So, for JA, first will be QA, second this is QB. For KA, this is for KA, okay? QA and QB will be inputs. For JB, QA and QB will be used. And for KB, QA and QB will be used. As I have already told you that we have to make use of our present states. We can't make use of our next states. So, QA and QB can only be used for these, for the calculation of JA, KA, JB, KB. And here, as we already know that our number of variables here is 2, which is QA and QB. QA and QB are the present states and we are using them only. So here n is equal to 2. So number of cells that we have to make in Karnaugh map is 2 raised to power n, which is 2 raised to power 2, and it gives us answer as 4. So 4 cells we will make, 0, 1, 2, 3 is the values for them. Here we will write 0, 1, here we will write 0, 1. And similarly for all of these 3 we have done the same. Now we will fill the values. For JA, we have to see the value which is 1. So here only one value is 1. So what we have to do, we have to make here, we have to make in 1th place as 1. So here we will write 1. Now here we will make use of cross as don't cares. Okay, so in this place we are having a cross and in this place also we are having a cross. So in 2nd place we are having a cross and in 3rd place we are having a cross. So just write a cross also. Here we are having a cross and here we are also having a cross. And in don't cares we have to make pairs as minimum as possible. So using this one we can make a pair and we can take one cross. So we are taking one and cross to make a pair. And why I am not taking these two, because don't care should have to be avoided as possible. So I am avoiding to make them a pair and I am trying to make this one with this cross a pair. So for this, this pair will be used. Okay, so don't care, this don't care we can neglect. Now for JA, what is the value? For JA we will have, see this, in this row nothing is common. Here we are having 0, here we are having 1, and here in this place we are having 1 as common. This is also taking 1, this is also taking 1. So JA value will come out as QB. Now we will move to KA. Now in QA we are having 1 in only this place, which is third place. So right here 1. Now see the don't care, because we can't make any pair using only one number of 1. So just see the crosses. Here we are having a cross and here we are having a cross. In 0 and 1 place we are having a cross. So right here cross and right here 1 cross. Now make pair as possible to avoid don't care cases. So we can make a pair like this also in this place. So I am avoiding to make this one as a pair, because we have to avoid don't care cases. Now I am taking this cross to make it with a pair with this one. So KA value we have to compute now. This is for KA value, this is for KA value. So here 0 is there and 1 is there, nothing is common. Now for this one, when we will move to the column, 1 is common in this place and 1 is also common in this place. So KA value will come out as QB again. Here K value will come out as QB. Now we will move with JB. Now in JB, in 0th place and in 2nd place 1 is there. So here we will write 1 and here also we will write 1 and we will make a pair out of it. Okay, and we will neglect the don't care cases. Okay. One more thing that we can do is, if we are taking the don't care cases also, if you are trying to take the don't care cases also, then we will have a case that all of them are filled. This will become the maximum group. Okay, maximum group, which is a quad. So here it is more useful, as we have to make a maximum group as possible. So instead of making a pair, instead of making them a pair, we will take don't care cases also, and we will make a big group, which is a quad group. So we are making a quad group here, and as it is combining all things, here we will have 0 1, here also we will have 0 1 0 1 0 1. Here nothing is common in the rows and nothing is common in the columns. So but we have to do, we will have a case which is logic 1 case. Okay, so JB value will become out as 1. So in this we are making use of don't cares, as you already know that we have to make a maximum group, and maximum group out of in this case can be formed if we are taking don't care cases also. And if we are not taking don't care cases, then we will have a pair group. Similarly for so we are taking here quad group, and similarly for this KB in 1 place and in 3rd place we are having 1. I hope you can see this. In 1 place and in 3rd place we are having 1. So 1 place and 3rd place we will take 1. And if we are taking cross also in 0th place and 2nd place, we will have a bigger group, which is a quad group. So we will, instead of taking a pair group, we will take a quad group. Okay, and this quad group will give us KB value as 1, which is logic 1. Okay, if whole the corner of map is covered, then we will have a case which is logic 1 case. So we will give the values final answer as 1 1 to that logic. Now we will construct circuit diagram using all these values. So how you have to construct circuit diagram is like this. Firstly, make a block diagram for first flip flop, then make block diagram for second flip flop. It is for first flip flop where JA, KA and QA are input output, and it is for second flip flop where JA, JB, QB and QB, JA, KB and QB are input output. Now make use of this. So in this, JA should be equal to QB. So just connect GA with QB. So we have connected it. Okay, now KA should be equal to QB. So KA should be equal to QB. So how we can connect it is like this. We will make a connection. Connection should be made like this, and we will connect it to KA. Now JB is should be equal to 1. So just give it logic 1 value right here, logic 1. Okay, and again next thing we have to do is KB. This is KB. KB should also be equal to 1. So we can take connection from here also, and we can give it to KB. Okay, so this up to this it is completed. Now we will have to find a clock. So here, as it is synchronous up counter and it is having negative edge clock, it is mentioned in the question. So negative edge clock should be made like this. See this. Draw a clock line for a clock. Give clock to first flip flop as well as second flip flop, as we are dealing with a synchronous counter. So the clock for this will be like this. Here we will make a knot. Okay, so this is negative edge clock, and here also we will make a circle, and this is negative edge clock. So in positive edge clock we just have to connect it. We don't have to make a small representation, that is circle, but in negative edge clock we have to make a circle. Okay, so this is negative edge clock. You can write here also negative edge clock, CLK represent clock. Okay, after this one thing that is left with us is output. So here QA, QB and QA will be the outputs. So just take one connection from here and make it QB, and just take one connection from here and make it QA, and this will become your outputs. So this construction of circuit diagram is completed. Just remember that in negative edge clock you have to make representation like this only. So this is the circuit diagram.